A data frame is a two-dimensional array, or to put it simply, a table. Data that is tabled into rows and columns makes it easy to work with in R and means we can store a mix of numeric, categorical variables, and character strings. Data frame is one of the main objects you'll be working with in R, so let's get ourselves familiar with it. So in our video on reading and writing data, you read in the income data set as a data frame. You can see a mix of data types here and the variable names. So data frame makes it easy to subset data in R. As you would have seen in our operations video, you can use conditions to extract out something you might be interested in. So for example, I might be interested in extracting out the average income for jobs that are, you know, above 90,000. So to do this, I just simply write income, and within my income data set, I use the dollar sign to refer to the variable that I'm interested in, which is average income. And I would like it to be greater than or equal to 90K. Now in our data frame income, we can refer to specific rows and or column names inside the square brackets here. So here we are specifically referring to rows that meet this condition. We want to extract all the rows where the average income value in the row is greater than or equal to 90,000. The comma that kind of follows this means that we can also extract at the column level. So you can basically say within income, we can specify the rows and we can specify the columns. So let's just say I'm interested in the third row of the third column. So what I'm saying here is I would like the income value that sits at row 3 of the average income column, which is the third column. And if we run this, you can see it has extracted the relevant value. The same goes for meeting a condition. So we just specify the rows we want before the comma. And if we want to specify any columns, we do this after the comma. We can also extract a range of rows and columns in our data set. So for example, I might want rows 1 to 3. And I only want the values from columns 1 to 2 of income. Now we can see the rows 1 to 3 showing and only columns 1 to 2 of those rows. In a data frame, we can easily add or remove columns too. So for example, to add a column, we simply type income. We'll use this dollar sign to add a variable. We'll just call it new column. And I'm just going to add a bunch of NA missing values to that just for the quick demonstration. Let's just have a look at this. Okay, cool. And now to remove a column, we follow similar kind of command here of income. And we want to kind of get rid of the fourth column. So kind of -4 here, which is the last column in our data set. Let's have a look. Okay, great. Now, another useful command in R is str, or what we call structure. So if we look at the structure of income, for example. So here we can see our numeric or character or categorical variables. We can see how many characters, categories or factor levels there are, how many rows of data we have to work with and the like. So now that you're familiar with data frames, we'll move on to vectors in the next video.